Good aggressive run. This game is on.
Huge hit on him. Through the hands. Excellent pass.
You cannot. This is picture perfect.
Oh, that's just brilliant. That's magnificent.
He has been on form today.
Can you believe it?
This is brilliant.
Totally demolishing the opposition. The rest is history.
Give the people what they want. SuperSport is bringing rugby back to the communities. And today in Rustenburg, it's Newrak Impala against East Rand United in a volcano Super Cup clash. This is the 23rd game at Impala Rugby Club to be broadcast live on SuperSport since 2015. And what a remarkable statement on club rugby development in South Africa that is. It is a fine day in Rustenburg, and I can tell you that max temper 23, we are nearing it, and just about no wind. Really wonderful conditions to be out here, and the spectators and the support base for Newrak Impala, they are known to be very loyal. Impala have won the Gold Cup 3 times. They are the reigning champions, so of course their support base and their tight-knit community have a good reason to be here today. We're going to look at the away side, starting off. Lentour, he played for Border, and then Ramat the wing played for Bulan, so a lot of experience. Thompson, 13, he's with the Falker. Roy played for the Lions, and Dustin Bosch is a giant of a ninth man. Nguni has a great amount of pedigree, as does Njomba. Buerta, the captain, is wonderful, and Klaas, the 39-year-old veteran, will bring a lot to this side. And Impala, if we look at their side, and we'll see that they've had a few changes, particularly since winning the Gold Cup. Some of their veterans remain. I'll tell you, Kolani Nkosi can get around the field, as can Itu Mpete. Kutsia played for the Cheetahs. Berto van Wyk, the captain's a great player, a great leader. Francois van Billion has a great pedigree. Lekransi is a strong player. And Andre Olafia is a veteran of the side. Have a look out for Maverick van der Merwe, who will be coming off the bench. I have the pleasure of being in the booth with a man who has a lot of experience. He's played against some of these men. He knows some of the coaching staff. He's been at the coalface. Fudge Mtunzi Mabeta, how wonderful is this setup? And how great is it that this is a working man's game and all of these players are amateurs who also have jobs?
Absolutely right, Anton Taylor. Beautiful conditions, some fantastic matchups we have this afternoon and this morning. But it's just so good to be here and to watch the true heart, people who really love the game of rugby. These guys are working men. They get home at midnight sometimes. They work an hour and a half from their training pitch. Amazing to see them come out here on a Sunday and give it their all on the pitch. Awesome to see. I think it's a brilliant time for rugby in South Africa. Make no mistake, these guys are the backbone and the spine of rugby in this country. A lot of them feeders for the big unions. It will be great to see.
Indeed it is. Joe Buerta, the man tasked with officiating today. We have 3 games today. What a bonanza and festival of rugby it is. After this and later on, well, the Leopards are going to be playing in the 3rd game of the day. They are the local side, and just have a look at that vista. What a beautiful setting for rugby. And Fudge was having a conversation earlier on, in the case of Impala, 80% of these players are employed by Newrak. So just to reiterate what Fudge was saying, really this is a community of men who work together, both sides in fact.
100%. There we see the man known as Makor Njomba. Look out for him. But the cohesive nature of this game, you'll see the teamwork. These guys work together and play together. Can't wait.
Thank you for that intro, Fudge. The game has begun by Cameron Lentour. And you'll notice there are some sizable players on both teams. Ethan Sears works it out. So with club rugby, you get bigger players. Sometimes mobility is not the same as the professional levels, but there's a great amount of skill and great level of rugby. Impala, a very structured side. CS works it out. Van Billion gives it to the backs, and it's the captain, Berto van Wijk. He's a teacher. And he's Rustenburg, born and bred. That's been knocked on. So this is a good opportunity now for East Rand United.
Blow, Loss.
Dustin Losch. The captain, JT Buerta.
No advantage. Knock on.
Well, Jonathan, that's Wayne Stradom making the hit. Good run from Jonathan Buerta. So the big boys making use of their size nice and early in the game. Ethan Sias, unfortunately, is missing his mark there.
Bye.
This will be a big battle up front.
Sit!
Oh!
Pops out the back.
Backwards.
Nguni. Threw it out and it's been cleaned up. Yonkers! Jackie Yonkers! Brilliant tackle upon him. Play still stayed in. Good run by Yonkers, but the tackle really crucial.
Great break. Jackie Yonkers. He could have just held on a little bit longer, maybe allowing a support player to ruck instead of take the ball.
Short line, well done, taken by Marius Breitenbach. And the big men used to bash it up. In that case, Henro Heiser. He's been a veteran, and he said earlier this year he wanted to win the Gold Cup for the third time. He has. Now the kick, Ethan Sias. Not a bad kick. Well read, well taken. Lentour. And Cameron Lentour's nickname is actually Libok.
Roll out.
In case you saw any similarity between him and the mercurial star of the Bulls.
A mistake coming in from the captain, Berto van Wijk, right in front of the post. So, the Pakisa Limited, East Rand United guys take the easy option. Looks like they're going for points. A good decision as far as I'm concerned. They've lost every game in the Gold Cup. So they'll be coming into this hoping to get a win as they both are equal in points. Both last on the logs.
The man they call the Roy Machine has missed it. So for now, the scores remain tied, nil all.
Mark Sikkerel is after the ball. After the ball, blow.
Through the hands now, East Rand United. Oh, he's misread it, going over the top. Bursting through, Machadiana. Gets out the pass to Berta van Wijk. Sias. It was Impeta earlier who went on the run. He's still alive. Some work for Lentour. Diminutive fast player runs into one of the biggest players on the field, Andre Olivier. It's 120 kilograms is Olivier. Now Losch with the kick over the top. Belisa is. And Impala bashing it up now. Sias. Quickly through the hands. Breitenbach, what a thing of beauty. Big man bulldozes across the field. Comes out quickly. Sias. Lechransi.
Offside. Backline offside.
Well, the intensity has definitely been put up a notch or two. Newrak making good use of ball in hand. They were unbeaten in the Gold Cup. The Newrak Impala men.
Trump.
Unfortunately, doesn't get it right that time over the dead ball line. So a scrum down to East Rand United.
Crouch. Bye. Set.
Losh.
Nine stay.
Speeds. The scrum turns a little bit. Nguni. Losh. Bursting through the gap. Final pass goes to Lentua. Beautiful pass. Ramat. And a hit on him by Machajana. Successful. Once again, lost possession.
Let's play the knock.
There's been some errors, but there have also been some beautiful passes and skills displayed thus far in these first 7 minutes.
No, precisely that, Anton Taylor. Coming from both sides, really. Good play, just unable to finish it off. Making some mistakes. Njomba passes it nice and short. Such a good ball. And if he goes down there and they get a phase, quick ball, you'd think they're scoring out wide. They had numbers. Unfortunately, unable to get that last play right.
Touch.
Looking good though, East Rand United.
Stand up.
Now Lawrence Sapaka, the forwards coach, helping out with scrummaging, has been helping the Pakisa Limited East Rand United front row.
Set.
CS feeds, takes, Van Billion, rather better Van Veek, the captain, man sporting a fine moustache. And now it's Van Billion. Does a jig, runs, puts in the boot, it's a big one. Lentur bounces straight into his hands. He puts it to his left foot. Has he overcooked it? Yep, he has. So this will be a good result for Impala.
Unfortunately, Lentur not getting it right, but it looked like there was some space. They tried to take a quick one. They'll come back for the line now. So Lentur looking for the space, not getting it right. Brilliant covering play from Xolani Nkosi, the Newrak Impala fullback. We saw him burst through the gap earlier. He's been covering well.
It's gone as array. Ripped up by Andre Olafia. Sias. Van Veek. Characteristic play of Impala is they like giving it to their big man with the pods, and now bursting through is one of them. Heysa.
Backwards.
Ball went backwards. Cameron Lentur. He's got so much pace. I think maybe towards the end of the game he might start running through some of these big men he's against. And Xolani Nkosi lets it go. Fudge, I want to ask you, you've got a huge amount of experience. Do players, they've played tons of games, do they still get nervous at the beginning of a match?
Of course, I get nervous at the beginning of every time I even hold the mic. So, of course, they do get nervous. The adrenaline's there. It's a big game. It's an official game. And you got to rise up to the occasion. All eyes are on you at the end of the day. You don't want to do anything embarrassing, do you, Anton?
The wealth of information is Fajim Beta. And Breitenbach didn't have to get too high off the ground. Big hit. Wow. Backwardsly mobile. Breitenbach worked it out to Van Billion. Turned over now. Waylon Thompson gets out the pass.
What was it?
Andres van der Merwe just couldn't handle it.
Not
And he looks like he's got some gas in him. Although he's a number four lock, looks like he could make a stride or two. Unfortunately, yeah, unable to get that one, but good work coming in from Waylon Thompson. Unfortunately, unable to get his hand on the ball. Applying some good pressure though, East Rand United. Keeping Impala right in their 22.
Bind. Set. Stay nine. Ball is out.
Yes. Go running right through the gap. Pete eventually comes down.
No 13.
Change of direction from Sias. Doesn't find a man initially, and then it's lost.
Sides, everybody.
No matter, all of the sides.
You and your side, number four. Both of you, sides. Number four and five, offside.
So, Francois van Billion, nicknamed Choppies, backing himself for a big kick. And you can see the East Rand United side, literally almost half of them offsides there.
Will Francois van Billion be able to get the first points on the scoreboard? Both sides looking quite equal.
Three, two. Max Vickerl is after the ball. Play, no, play.
Play taken. East Rand United keen to run it.
No.
Losh.
Backwards.
Fly up Roy, had to reach up to it. Fine hands from him. Losh again. And every time you look at Losh, he's so big, he could be a hooker. Gets around the field though. Mpete and Machajana have swapped jerseys, as have Nkosi and Fabillion. So it's Mpete that works it out. Sias. Stepping from JP Kutsia. He's born in George and attended Oakdale. Now with time, the kick comes in. And oh, a few centimeters could have been the difference, but that's heartbreaking again.
Unlucky Francois van Billion, kicking just not going right for either side. East Rand United apparently have quite a good line out, according to Lawrence Sapaka. I'll be looking to attack now. In this good position on the pitch.
Bakumeni takes it, buys it out, now to the back line. Roy. Wrapped up.
Play, let the ball.
Losh. That's a picket and driven by the captain, JT Buerta. Lovely handoff. Almost lost the jersey. Good momentum now. Backwards momentum in that case. Berto van Veek with the hit on Sean De Vet.
Ball is in the air.
And it's been turned over. Sias. Nkosi. Steps. Runs inside, gets out the pass. Marius Breitenbach. And a couple times in this match, that final pass just not going to hand now.
Well, Impala have had a couple of opportunities to counter-attack. The dangerous Tolani Nkosi did did well to get away the pass, but unfortunately unable to hold it. They'd gone through the phase there. They might have been able to make some ground, maybe get it deep into the East Rand United territory. So because of that knock, even though they turned the ball over and had an opportunity to put some pressure on East Rand United, East Rand United keep the ball. Now I have another opportunity to attack.
Fudge, what do you make of those stats?
72% of the territory being played, 72% of territory being played in the Impala half. So that is not what you want to see as a coach. Makes it very difficult for Impala to have any chance of scoring points, where East Rand United, we've seen them go for post twice. So unable to capitalize, but sooner or later they will. So the pressure on Impala so far is looking really good for East Rand United, although Impala's been their own worst enemy, haven't they? Knocking the ball on at some critical moments where they could have gotten deep into the territory. Also, that missed kick where they had an opportunity to get down onto the 5 meter and have a line out. You know, they've got a really good line out to Impala, although they've missed one or two.
At this point, we're just standing still. No one's got to move from the
back. That's the big man, Andries van der Merwe.
29 years old. He works as a technician.
Awesome to see how keen these guys are. A lot of them in some great condition as well.
Time on.
Speak of Dustin Losh, he's been getting around the park really well. Impressed by his work rate for a big guy.
He's 106 kilograms. It's been a while since I saw a scrum of that size.
Crouch.
Since the days of Byron Kelleher.
Yeah.
Bind. Set. Does it slip? Yeah, come on, Skye. We can not all.
The advantage of having such a big scrum off is that when it is a little bit scrappy at the back of the ruck, as it tends to be, especially on that turnover ball, you've got a strong nuggety guy who can pick up the ball and take it up. Gives the big men a little more time to get to that ruck, get into their shape and attack.
Crouch. Bind. Set.
Dustin Losh, nicknamed Dusty, takes off the back of a pretty stationary scrum. Roy cuts out the pass. Well, where that socket would have been a great boot, but in this case, sailed out. I'm not sure if it came off someone.
Knock on.
Yeah, knock on the call.
Scrum, knock on yellow.
Well, that pass, not getting it right, is the Roy machine, Cameron Roy. But how good were those skills? Cameron Lentour, I tell you what, if that had gone through, it would have been a chase. Still playing in that Impala half.
Crouch. Bind. Stand up, both sides. Remember the gap, please.
Interesting to see if Impala choose to run it up a few phases or if they actually start playing that territory game.
Fudge, I was having... we are linked. I was having the exact same thought. Van Billion's not standing too deep, so I don't think they're going to... I don't think the kick's the option.
Bind!
They play very direct rugby.
Early, number one.
That's a careless, unforced error.
It's early.
Andre Engelbrecht, number one for Impala, not getting it right. Early engage.
And Mjomba, nicknamed McCaw. And we'll see throughout the game if he deserves that nickname, but quickly now through the hand. Lentur gets out the pass to Ramat. Ramat continues going. Man who played for Boerland. Losh finds it.
No, Boerter.
Now Losh finds his lock, and Boerter again. Good momentum from East Rand United. Through hands, overlap, and he's through. Lovely try. East Rand United draw first blood.
They kept knocking on the door. They kept making mistakes. Great line coming in from Waylon Thomas. The big man stumbles over, and it's a good finish. Brilliant play from this East Strand United backline. Their coach, Colin Lloyd, got a world of experience, coached in Romania in 2011. He played wing and fullback for Western Province, the Griquas, and actually the Leopards right here. So a man who scored the most tries in the 2006 Curry Cup season. He'll be really happy with how the backline is looking. Looking really smooth and silky. Brilliant play from East Rand United.
Roy's kick. Doesn't find its mark. So we're in a five-point game. Halfway through the first half.
There we see the big man, Dusty Losh, pass it, but that's the pass. Great pass coming in from the Roy machine. Waylon Thompson on that short line finishes it off. Look at the big work done by Jonathan Buerta first, though. Fantastic play. High fives, East Rand United.
Choppies van Billion restarts. And he studied at Corp season, played at Cheetahs.
Feet on the ground.
Played Craven Week for Griffins, having attended Kroonstad. So now East Rand United using their big men to bash it up now to the back line. Cut out pass, Lentour, the try scorer. Just taken by the ankles. His opposite number, JP Kutsia. That was a great take. Pass as well. Some fine displays of hands. The captain, Buerta, fires it out. Jackie Jonkers carves in field, hoofs it up. And, well, I'll tell you what, that was not a bad kick at all.
Not bad at all. Dumi Makesha now probably does the right thing in the end, but how good is Jackie Jonkers? Switches on the pace, pushes enough pressure. And Dumi Makesha now does the right thing, dots it down well.
Whipped out. And this time it's Lachransi. Through the hands. And over it so quickly was Tian Ramat.
Number 14. Side. From the back side position.
Still Impala struggle to get out of their half. Not coming up with anything challenging enough for this East Rand United defense. Itumpete, try scoring machine. What a player he is. JP Kutsia can't make any ground. He's a little bit isolated, and look at how the outside backs of East Rand United attack that ruck. Really good play from them.
So the Roy machine, a man born and raised in East Lanton. Let's see if he can get a third time lucky. Oh, that is not one of his better kicks. It was missed by a player tying his shoelace, and now the hoof comes in from Van Billion. Kept in field. Fine line by the captain. Still going. Buerta gets it out now to Jonkers. Jonkers has brought electric pace onto this game. That's a big hit from 8-8. Lachransi on Mnguni. Losh manhandled. Lentour. I'll tell you, East Rand United saving their lives. Andre Olafia was coming in like a freight train. But Cameron Roy now.
High tackle.
And they've earned themselves a penalty. That was a high tackle.
Leave him.
Well, he was being held back. But Bakumeni goes on the run. And did you notice his own player trying to pull him back? Well, they weren't back 10, though, so no matter.
Wow. Well, if Kolekile Bakumeni's intent is anything to go by. This East Rand United side wants to play. Scrap you or not, it's all about the work rate, and these guys are working so hard. Every mistake Newrak Impala is making, East Rand United is making them pay for it, keeping ball in hand, putting pressure on them, causing them to make that unforced error, whether it's a penalty or a knock-on. Exceptional play from the side from East Rand United.
So Cameron Lenter has now taken over the kicking duties. It's his first attempt of the day. Cameron Roy benched in this regard. Boom! Got it! And the right decision to put him in.
He's got the magical boots on, does Cameron Lentour. Proving to be an asset to this East Rand United side so far in this fixture.
Van Billion, the man who works as a safety officer, sends it high. Jackie Jonkers, every time. His nickname is Sevu Reese. And Sevu Reese, if you didn't know, is the Fijian who plays wing for the Crusaders. A change of direction from the captain. JT Buerta has been full of running. Played his age group rugby at the Falka. Cut out pass. There would have been some hearts and mouths with Cameron Lentour up for it. He runs into Buerta van Wyk and van Billion. Final pass comes out. Look at the acerbic pace of Tian Ramat. Basketball pass goes to hand. Jomba was hunted there. Ramat, who does occasionally play nine, did well there. This time it's the fly half who gets out the pass. Buerta, big Hanre Kutsia. Jonkers puts in a goose step. Good tackle on him. Ball left to right. Cleaned up by Andries van der Merwe. Jonkers again. Tell you what, he had his energy earlier. Oh, that's spilt, but spilt backwards. No matter. Sean De Wet. He actually grew up in Potchefstroom.
Lost. Yen.
Born Potchefstroom, rather. He grew up in Boxburg. Still in position of East Rand United. The crash ball coming from the big man, the scrum off. Isn't it handy having a guy like him to run it off? Njomba. Roy Machine works it out. Nutmegged. Nguni. Captain Delmas this time, as well as Nigel. Njomba. Mwaniso. Haven't really seen him too much. Now it's been ripped from him.
Knock on in the tackle, number four. Not a deliberate tackle.
And that last play, the last 10 seconds we just saw, is how things have been going for Impala. Whether East Rand United is going backwards or forwards, what they are doing is they're at ruck time, they are reacting to the ball. They knock the ball on. You'd think Impala have an opportunity to set it up and counter-attack. Unfortunately, just not making the right decisions at those critical moments. And although they do have the scrum down, they're still in their half. And East Rand have an opportunity to get their line in order and compete the scrum.
Fudge, I wonder, I'd like to know your opinion. So I've always seen Impala, they like to play structure. They like using their big men off the ruck, and they often then pass it out. They're struggling, it seems, today to do that. It seems that East Rand United are just swarming, putting on pressure. Would you agree with that assessment? I mean, what would you say the difference between these two teams is this first half hour?
Look, 100%. East Rand United coming into this game definitely as underdogs. Although Impala have lost a couple of their main players after that unbeaten Gold Cup run of theirs, they just seem to not be making those right decisions. You get the turnover, they defended really well now in that last set of play. They defended well, they get the ball back. Unfortunately, you want them to go down to ground, find the space in behind the East Rand United and counter-attack. They haven't been able to do that. So every time they get the ball, they're getting the ball in either a scrum or a line-out, but they're deep in their own half. So they don't really have the luxury of running it out wide. Yes, they are a very direct team. They remind me a lot of the old-school Blue Bulls, actually, where you take it up with the forwards, you take it up with the forwards, you look for some space, you kick it. Unfortunately, that takes some good decision-making, and I don't feel like they've gotten that right. So attacking from a scrum, it's not very easy, especially deep in your own half.
Crouch. Bind. Set.
See us. Let's see what the back line can do. Berto van Veek. JP Kutsia. He was well read. He's a learner electrician. Through the hands. Van Billion's attempt over the top goes awry. Cleaned up by Breitenbach. Olani Nkosi, nicknamed Zulu. He's a learner boilermaker himself. He was playing for Impala 2018 and 2017. Now, see us. This time it's Andre Olafia. Van Veek.
Los, Giel. Giel, los.
Found.
Too many bodies.
Well, that's a big boy. Look at this unders line. Run very well in by Tumi Macheshana. Brilliant defense, though, by Jonathan Puerta. Slowing the ball down. And Impala just not reacting quick enough at ruck time. Getting slow ball, and they have another scrum. They've made about 20 meters since their last scrum. A good play by Dumisani Macheshana to get them over the advantage line.
I just can't believe what unbelievable condition Dumi Macheshana is. He's 38.
Set.
Played for the Sharks in Super Rugby and Blitzbox, but he's probably the best conditioned player on the field. Now Van Billion. And the man we spoke about, well, good tackle on him by Waylon Thompson.
Last footer.
Kick comes over. See us. It's being hunted by Mpete. Lentour. Comes from King Williamson. There are a couple players today from King Williamson. That is a fine kick. Cameron Lentour. Take a bow.
That's just individual brilliance. The way he covered that ball and to get so much ground with a kick deep in your 22. Fantastic play. Brilliant fullback play from Lentour. And it's absolutely heartbreak for Newrak Impala, who are now right back on their 5-meter line after looking for some space and good attack, getting deep into the East Rand United half.
Over the top, no matter, the big man, the scrum. Oh. Dustin Losh, good luck stopping him.
Oh, he's a big boy, Dustin Losh, and he plays a big game. It's a missed throw. Losh is right at the back of that. The big man so close, no stopping him.
Oh, he's got a freshly lined up cut as well. That must have helped him.
He's been so busy. Really doing well in the loose, close to the ruck, causing problems for Impala, always asking questions, and there he gets rewarded. Nice to see.
Into he's been on form with the boot today and in other aspects. Another one.
Cameron Lentour. Absolutely brilliant kicking performance for him. But look at the big man, Dusty Losh. Great play to take it off the back of a missed line out from Impala. They keep putting on the pressure. They're playing rugby in the right areas. And that is why they're leading 15-0.
And the restart comes in. Losh actually ran over a forward there. Yonkers. He's taken by Henro Heiser. Heiser, 126 kgs. Andrew Kutsia waits for it, takes it, runs onto it, earns a few meters. The one in Benoni was Kutsia.
Lost, no, blow yourself.
The pressure we were talking about, Fudge, that swarming.
Too many bodies. No, no, no. If you're from your feet off, you're going to penalize it. Too many bodies. Gelukkig het geel op jou gedijk.
Well, Cornelius Smith gets told by the referee, you're lucky you didn't get penalized for being off your feet, but he has a good goal for the ball. The rucking is good. He's then off his feet, so he can't have another goal. He should release. The referee gets it spot on there, I believe.
Crouch.
He had a goal. He has to let go.
Bind.
Once you're off your feet.
Set.
Nguni feeds Losh. Roy.
Okay, Losh, so blow yourself. Come here, thank you. Gotcha.
Well, the referee says that's too much chirping. And Newrak Impala not happy with the decisions the referee's been making at ruck time.
Number six swearing.
And they'll need to check themselves out. Wayne Stradom, the one there. Looks like he's been sent off.
For language.
Yep, for language, Anton Taylor. So, of course, frustrations will be building. They just haven't had any answers.
Well, I'll tell you, I'm not sure how much you pick up at home, but I can confirm that Wayne Stradom was guilty from what we could hear. When last did you hear a player being sent off for language? But your Boerter running a good shift, eh? Cameron Roy back in the kicking mix and still not finding his way.
22.
Well, the referee, Mr. Boerter, saying there will be none of that. It is scrappy at ruck time.
Van Billion doesn't find touch. Lentour, dynamite package. He is beats the defender now. Does he have the pace? Looking for the pass, gets it out. Tian Ramat scores, but what a brilliant play from Cameron Lentour.
Absolutely sensational play. This man put on his magical boots. Look at the pace on the man. It looked like he was going to go all the way. He's got presence of mind to pass it short. Brilliant play. What a finish from Tian Ramat. The speed to actually catch up to him and support his fullback, the brilliant Lentour. Sensational play from East Rand United.
It's a great point, Fudge, because Lentour was like a rocket. So you actually really do have to appreciate then, as you point out, the support play of Ramat to be in the right position.
Huge effort from him, huge effort from every man on this side. 1-15, really working hard in this first half.
Cameron Lentour, the man who made the try, and who's been on form and on song with the boot, back into the kicking position. It's a tricky angle, as you can see. Unlucky. Lentour having a day to be remembered. That's a try scorer.
That's brilliant. Look at this. He's so quick. His turn of speed is just exceptional. And look when he starts looking for the support. Great support by Ramat. What a try. Look at the excitement on the bench. Yeah, it's just going right for them. Sensational play.
And Fudge, that reaction, that's what this rugby is all about. It's about the community. Perhaps no one loves rugby as much as these men because they're not getting paid to do it.
Knock on.
And of course, there might be errors from time to time as the Roy machine just takes his eyes off the ball.
And they've been perfect up until that one mistake. Every single kickoff, they've taken it well. They've put their structures together. They've looked really, really silky smooth. And that man, the Roy machine, not getting it right there. He's played brilliantly, though. He'll be blaming on Dusty Losh, the big man, for his pass.
Bind. Set.
What can Impala bring?
See us. Goes blind, but it goes over the top of Mpete. Now it's come off a boot. This is trouble. Look at the pace of Lentura. Hunting it. Bounces up. Gets it to a boot. Just evades him. Mpete dives upon it. He has no support, however. Burst backwards. The captain, Berta van Wyk, desperately sorts it out. Presents it back. All sorts of pressure being put on. But over-enthusiastic for East Rand United.
Number three,
Sardi. Just coming in on the side. But wow, East Rand United. Any small opportunity, any loose ball, and these guys are reacting to it brilliantly. Really good work by Itumpete to clean it up. That man does really well as well, Berto van Wyk. So a last opportunity for Impala to do something in this first half.
As Fudge says, last chance saloon, works out. Breitenbach pops it down quickly to CS and immediately it's bashed up. It was a short line out. Cycle quickly. This is better, more traditional Impala play. As Neil Smith, who himself is also a teacher, lost forward on the siren. And that final play, perhaps the story of Impala's first half. Fudge and Beta, any thoughts on the first half?
Yeah, just like you say, Anton, the perfect summary of what's happened for Impala in this first half.
Cappy.
But East Rand United. Cappy. The men from the rough and tough Reiger Park have come to play. It's been scrappy at times, but they've kept their discipline. They've worked hard and they've pitched up. Haven't won a game this year yet. They're looking brilliant. Halftime score, 20 to East Rand United, 0 to the home side, Newrak Impala. What a first half.
Can you believe it?
This is brilliant.
Demolishing the opposition. The rest is history.
It's club rugby at its finest at Impala Stadium. East Rand United, the away side, lead Impala 20 points to nil at halftime.
And it makes a huge difference, that right there, Anton. Every mistake you make is so much more costlier when you're in your 22 or close to your try line. Gives the opposition an opportunity to counter-attack, catch you off guard, score some points, or to put some points on by going for posts. Be interesting to see what Impala do. I believe they need to improve their work rate, work a little bit harder off the ball and at ruck time to maybe get that ball and test East Rand United, who have just been given so much quick ball.
Frontal Van Billion sends it up, well pursued. And because of that pressure, causes an error and the perfect start for Impala to the second half.
That's exactly what they'll be hoping for. Put some pressure on that kickoff, get back that 50-50 ball. It was an exceptionally placed kickoff for them. The number five goes up very well. Kolekile Pakumeni just unable to collect it though. That 50-50 cut. Falls to the Impala side. They've got a rare opportunity now to attack.
Set.
And reserves have come on for both sides. CS, Van Billion, It was rather Berta van Wyk.
Tackle.
You see, Berta van Wyk is carrying a fine moustache as well as a ball. Now it's Henro Heysa who bashes it up. Sias got the pass out.
Oh, and you know what? They've done so well from that scrum. They've kept it direct. Look at the pressure at ruck time, though, coming from the East Rand United side. Just puts a little bit of pressure on the scrum off Ethan Sias. And he gets out a 50-50 ball to Andre Olifir, who isn't able to collect. Actually, none of the 50-50 passes have been able to be collected from Impala. So get out of jail free for East Rand United.
Stand up. Move the gap here, Daikan. Keep the gap, please.
Hanriel Kutsia and Saki Klaas, 39 years old. The tight head
prop
doing so well for East Rand.
Set.
At scrum time.
Saki Klaas says his aim in rugby is to play till he's 42. So just 3 years away. Now Losh allows Nguni to change the direction. Thompson. Yonkers ducked under the tackle there from Machajana. Sean DeVette. Well juggled, well handled. Hanriel Kutsia. Kutsia is a teacher. Can you even imagine having a teacher that size? Must have the most best disciplined class in the world. Olali Nkosi puts in the goose step. Still goes a bit more forward. Sears. Van Billion. The player staying a bit flat footed. And it's a new man to the field, Sheldon Gibson. Now the kick comes in. In pursuit is Machajana. It bounces up beautifully for him. And the 39-year-old gets out the pass. And Gerald Gibson finishes off Impala back in the game.
Gerald Gibson, fresh legs, comes onto the pitch. It was him and Dumi Makeshana chasing down that kick. The bounce goes Dumi's way. The big man has got too much strength. Offloads it, almost fumbled by Gibson. He takes it in the end and finishes off a well-worked try. And what a start to the second half by Newrak Impala. Just what the doctor ordered.
Van Billion with an important kick. He's at two. Could Fudge, I want to ask you, in club rugby, obviously the conditioning can't be the same at the same level as professional rugby. What is the difference in these guys' fitnesses between, say, a Varsity Cup or Curry Cup player?
Well, we've seen how well they chased this up. That's some really good fitness. One of the most conditioned men on the field, you've mentioned. Look at Gibson. So his legs are still fresh, but look, almost every single player on this pitch has been playing at a frantic rate, and it's good to see. They take care of their conditioning very well, personally.
Thank you, Fajar, because I wonder about how the game will change. And Pete kept it in and then threw it over.
Take him back.
Oh, yeah, not a great moment. I was wondering about the second half because this is when the difference in fitness can start to show. And it appeared as if Impala were coming back, but not their greatest moment there.
Well, it comes back down to their decision-making, doesn't it? They let the ball bounce there. Mbete then doesn't let it go out. It would be their line-out. He then tries to juggle it. He makes a long pass on the inside. So it's just a string of bad decision making during a pressure point, a kickoff, a 50-50 ball. You want to take it cleanly and set it up for the exit.
Cut. Bind. Set.
Wait. Puertas handled the breakdown and the scrummaging really well, the referee this morning. It'll be so interesting to see, Anton, if this East Rand United side can keep up to this pace they've been playing at.
Bind.
Now with the scrum, I've got the option of Big Nguni and Losh.
What do they do?
So Nguni tapping it, picks it up himself. Walks it over, takes five.
The big man, Peter Nguni, finishes off some stellar work. Look at that scrummage. The Springbok, Lawrence Sepaka, will be so proud of the pack he's been coaching. What a finish. Coaches are happy. They deserve to be happy. Can you believe this side has lost so many games this year? They are looking totally transformed.
And although it has not been the best season for Impala, and they've lost three of the matches, this is the reigning club side in the country that East Rand United are busy, you know, in the process of beating.
Really strong side, playing at home, very hard to beat. They've been prepared for it, working so hard off the ball. Good to see.
Oh, Len Tour, isn't he having a day to remember, Fudge?
Len Tour, he's so still with his kicks. So rapid at the back, but look at the scrummaging. They get the left shoulder. That's what they wanted. Brilliant work by Kutsia and Klaas in the front. And what strength shown by Nguni at the back to finish it off.
It's a short restart. There's a proper battle for it. It comes out in the hands of Njomba. Losh picks out his man, had several options, whipping across the back line. Waylon Thompson, in his hometown is Reicha Park, into her school Voortrekker. JT Buerta, he had a busy first half. He's going on a run now. The kick, where will it bounce? And Mpete reads it well. Plays fullback as well, so he's got some experience under the high ball. And a penalty now for Impala.
Off the feet and hands.
Itumpete being kept busy out on his wing. Does well to collect and clean that up. It's a good option for East Rand United. They're just changing their point of attack consistently, communicating so well. Look at the hard work done from the man from Itumpete. Hard work. Rare opportunity for Impala to capitalize. They need to get this right.
Got some big men lurking in the back line. Goes over Breitenbach's head. There's been a stumble.
Boys. Let's open the gap.
Well, you're the specialist, Fudge. What's happening here?
Starts, close the gap.
Well,
take the line up.
I'll tell you this much. The number two, Robert Randall, cannot really be the man blamed here. It seems like the players inside the line out are just in sixes and sevens and not getting things right.
Time off.
Seems as if they'll go for the line out again. They have a little chat, a little meeting to sort themselves out. All of them get on the same page.
Time is off.
They'll need that.
Time is off.
How good has he been? Hanriel Kutsia, a scrum machine at the front. Epitome of a loose head prop. Been running it well, has taken the ball up a few times. Proven to be an asset for this East Rand United side. And like I said, from number one all the way to number 15, the magician Lentour at the back, they've pitched up today and they've worked hard for that scoreline.
Time on.
Randall now this time finds Hayser. So the line-out works second time around. Van Billion finds his man. Sias. Fine hands from Andre Olafia.
Leave it.
His dad to Andre and married to Cindy. And he has been with Impala for almost a decade. The penalty.
Hold on.
Ooh.
Captain.
Roberta has something to say.
It's not enough. It's not a fourth penalty. It's not a vierde penalty. But iemand van hulle is te taf, okay? Okay. Hy kyk vir my, ek sê vir hom los en hy gaan aan. So ek praat met hom, sy laaste keer.
Well, as Jonathan Buerta brings in the tied five, or all eight of the pack actually, tells them that it's a little bit too much at ruck time now. Gives them a warning, so they don't want to get that right. They don't want to let this game slip away. They've been working hard. We hope those legs aren't getting weary. He's told to let go of the ball. You see he's not supporting his weight, and the referee again gets it spot on. The last thing. This Pakisa Holdings Limited East Rand United side will want is to let it go through ill discipline.
Boris van Jaarsveld coming to the field. 130 kilograms he is. So. Perhaps at 130 kilograms, it's best to come on with half an hour left. A real impact player, and he's a learner minor. He played for the Falke in 2013. The Falke, of course, playing later on.
Number one, yellow. One yellow.
Like you say, it just fascinates me that these players have got the discipline and the love of the game to keep in such good condition. We've seen some rapidly paced rugby out there. Look, there've been a bit of mistakes, but they've done really well. As the big man, Hanriel Kutsia, comes off the field. What a day he's had. I'll tell you one thing, Anton Taylor, these players will be happy to take a little break during that strapping. I'm sure the number two, Robert Randall, will be strapping that arm again just to get a little breathe. It's hot out there.
Robert Randall with newly attended strapping to his elbow. Joins the back of the party. Two more join. Rolling, he goes down 5 meters out. Are they going to whip it out or use the big man? Bert van Wyk, the captain, wrapped up by a wall of yellow. Sears, Breitenbach. Strong defense from East Rand United. Sears, fine pass. The step comes in from Wayne Stratum. He coming in from the sin bin after having had a potty mouth. Wow, that defense, Fudge.
Look at the look of the man with the ball in his hands. Jonathan Buerta. He's tattooed up, he's extremely well conditioned, and he's come to play. Unbelievable defense coming from East Rand United. Sibongile Makonjomba also being brilliant. Such good tackles being made by the loose trio of East Rand United.
11.
Look at how quickly he gets over that ball, but that's not impressive. The impressive part is how he stays on his feet to finish competing for that brilliant strength. Huge play coming in from him.
Luzuku Ndanda, man born in George, comes onto the field. He's a client liaison officer. A couple of them for East Rand United. Dusty Losh has whipped it out. Lentour. He had his work cut up to him. Gerald Gibson was on him quickly. It's hard to stop Lentour. Spat out on the floor. Berto van Wyk, the captain, goes on a run. And there's a host of men waiting for it. Such fine hands from the prop. That's Andre Olafia. He has been on. What was going on with that handoff? Is this really a forward? Goodness me! Changes jersey to a 10, and that is a beautiful try, capped off by Itu Mpete.
the speedster, Itumeleng Mbete.
Six blue.
Finishes off some brilliant play, but look at this. Fresh legs in Danda. Gets handed off. What a huge handoff, but it was the quick hands out wide to Itumpete. Brilliant play from Newrak Impala, who seemed to have improved and increased the pace. Mpete is getting the crowd going. If these guys have gotten it right, we see some players down with some cramps as well. It's going to be very difficult in the last 25 minutes of this match. We've got a huge game on our hands now.
We've spoken about the second half, about the conditioning. And of course, rugby, a game of confidence, a game of momentum. Tell you what, Neil Smith, if he gave that handoff in a club, he'd have spent the night in prison. But here he's rewarded with a try and applause. Van Billion from the corner. Doesn't get it.
Unlucky from them, but this Newrak Impala side is just looking new. Look at Cornelius Smith. Huge handoff. Still has the presence of mind to keep pushing. He places the ball really well. Scrum off does well to get there quickly. Brilliant hands out to Itumpete. Ah, that's how it goes. Henro Heise with a brilliant pass out to him.
Game in our hands. Van Billion with time sends it upfield. Touch found. And now we're going to have a look at those lineouts again.
Look, that's a classical exit. That's what they wish they were doing in the first half. And Newrak Impala seem to have sorted themselves out now. They all seem to be on the same page.
No, stay tuned.
Taken by CJ Pale. Roy holds on to it, stabs it up. Well read, Olani Nkosi. His goal, he says, is to be the best he can for the team. And the hands, it's that man, the fender, Neil Smith.
Number three of sides.
Taken quickly. Sias, he's got it out, the ball stays alive, a real roll and tumble. This could be trouble. There's a warning earlier. Yeah. Beautiful sportsmanship there. Andre Olafier helps him up.
Yeah, unfortunately, he's been a stalwart. Worked so hard as Bongile Mako Njomba. Doesn't get it right there. Maybe the legs are starting to get weary, but momentum has taken a significant shift. Njomba leaves the pitch now. He'll spend a few minutes. He'll come back just before the end of the game. But Impala, with an extra man now, within the 22 of their opposition, East Rand United, a rare occasion for them, just at the right time.
The line out. Oh, doesn't work for him. It's been intercepted.
Accidental. The ball bounced from him to him. Accidental offside.
You need those set pieces to work at this stage.
Yeah, no, you really have to. You can't capitalize on getting a penalty if you're not going to take your line out. And no one even goes up that time. Like I said, I don't want to blame the throwing of Robert Randall. He seems to be getting it right. It just seems like people aren't getting the call right. People don't really know what's happening. It's a communication issue, and they'll need to fix that ASAP. Whether they need to go to the front of the line now just to secure the ball, because momentum is in their hands, and they're literally throwing this game away now.
Bind. Set. Just a slip. Slip. Ball wasn't in yet. Slip. Let's just move.
On the other hand, Pakisa Limited, East Rand United, has been exceptional at set phase time. They've taken almost every single one of their lineouts. They're sitting at a 90% lineout rate. You know, they've taken every single scrum of theirs. So brilliant to see them doing so well.
Set!
Oh.
Losh feeds, takes, gives it to Roy. Roy holds out. Beautiful cut-out pass. Mento. Jonkers. We haven't seen him for a while. He certainly hasn't lost any energy. And Losh has not got tired. An opportunity. That was miraculous stuff from Berto van Wijk. Pulled off his fingertips. Changes possession again. And the kick from Peter Ngumbi. The hunt is on. Olani Nkosi. Oh, he was wrapped up, and what a chase from Nguni. Unbelievable stuff. The kick and the chase worthy of a fullback. And he's 30 years old. Unbelievable. Inspiring. Makes me feel young. And now Ethan Sias, born in Darling, works it out. Breaks through, does the new man to the field. Maverick van der Merwe finds Van Billion. He gives it to Marius Breitenbach, nicknamed out. Mace. Suspect not because of his size, but rather because of his name. It's been turned over.
Take a bow, Calvin Yankees. What a turnover.
Indeed it was. Now the hunt is on. Cameron Lentour. Oh! Crushing pressure.
My goodness, look, it's only fair it happens to East Rand United. It's been happening to Impala the entire morning. Wow, how unlucky was the magician there?
You know, it almost had to balance it out because he's had the perfect day.
Looks like he comes off his boot there. Well, the magician looks like he scored a try there, but the referee was so far behind him. You know,
well, look, between him and Honro Kutsia, they certainly don't think they scored. He's like, at least he doesn't feel robbed.
Let's go.
Fudge. Okay, analyze this for us.
Slows down. Just watch that left boot. He kicks that, doesn't he? He kicks that, and he knows he scores. He does it like he knows he scores. So,
cut.
Unlucky. For Cameron Lentour.
And now Lentour works as a driver, so he's going to have a lot of time to think that over on the roads.
He's just a brilliant player.
Yeah.
Unbelievable talent. I definitely don't expect Mr. Buerta, the referee, to keep up with that kind of pace. Does so well to grab it and keep it inside and still burn everyone. So what a player Lentour is.
Six.
Sias comes up quickly for him. Van Wijk onto that pace. Ran over Roy, but then went down. So much pressure being put on Impala. Kick comes in. Jonkers. Now let's look at the pace man run. Beats the first. And it's popped up magically. Dumi Machetiana, and again. Spilt out.
No hands.
And Corsi, when he fell upon it. Up for running on both these sides. Berto van Wijk gets out the pass, as does Maverick van der Merwe. Now we're talking. Itu Mpete gets a pass out. Still going. The fresh legs of van der Merwe. Sias, he's fit, was there when needed. Interesting option. And well, what do you think of that, Fudge?
A little bit too high, that option. I'm not sure if Itu Mpete was ready for it.
Time off, relax. Time off.
But wow, Impala playing at a scintillating pace. It's coast to coast rugby. Ndanda does really well to keep up with Mpete there. The ball did stay infield.
Okay. Captain. Tijd is af. Oké. Net een early tackle. Voordat die bal geraakt heeft. Dus ga niet penalty nemen, maar die bal. Nee, penalty ook niet. Oké. Nee, penalty. Dat is een penalty. Early tackle. On the line. Can't be a penalty try. Early tackle.
Well, the referee says it can't be a penalty try. It's an early Scrum. Tackle. Luzu Kondanda tackling that man, Itumpete,
Scrum off.
Early. Scrummy saw a bit of space. I'd say it was the kick was just a little bit too high. And that is an early tackle. Itumpete looked like he had gotten past him there. Look, nothing in it. Touch and go. 50-50 decision. Good to see it go Impala's way.
Penalty. Yeah, I don't. But the ball was a penalty, and I see a penalty try of Kilcourt.
So
that looks like the big man, Kolekile Bakumeni, the man from Masibonisane High School in King Williamstown.
And that was a defender.
He's been brilliant today. He's taken every single line out for them. He's done well on kickoffs, and those are the players who've been rocking.
Yeah.
This entire morning, definitely
nine
been
blue.
Doing their fitness back
nine
at home.
Blue.
Good to see.
Impala,
well, his nickname is Buckies, and he's got a wealth of experience. Stop. He played for Hollywood Swallows in 2016 and Berlin Tigers. Interestingly, both those sides are based in the Eastern Cape, neither Germany or America, as you may have thought. Well, Stefan Kreer is now coming onto the field. Under his rugby goals, he listed, I want to score an intercept tries. Everyone else is talking about playing for the Springboks. And Kreer just wants the intercept. So we'll see. He's got 17 odd minutes to make his dream come true.
More than enough time. And he's put it into the universe. Let's see what happens. They'll have to take the scrum first, though.
Kraut. Bind.
Pretty even with penalties and turnovers conceded.
It's not a new problem, United. We have the same problem.
Just been able to capitalize so well on those mistakes. It just hasn't gone Impala's way in terms of keeping the ball in hand, knocking the ball on in critical stages of a counter-attack.
Bind.
Another opportunity here.
Set! Both down. Scrum.
So what happened there, Fudge?
Legs are tired, players are getting frustrated. There's nothing in the scoreline. You know, 15 points separating them. And best believe, out of all the legs on the pitch, those two front rows, although they've had some substitutes, they'll be very tired.
And is the issue coming in because they're not hitting each other straight on and they're getting the angle wrong? Is that why it's collapsing?
Well, the spacing will be different. Remember, they've had two substitutes in that front row, so spacing will be different. They want to get that right. They do that time. Big shove coming in from Impala. Can they go all the way?
Kreer dots it down. We might have to have a look. But if he's got it, that was a dominant forward display.
Step.
The engage is good, but look at how the Impala side keep pushing their legs. Huge work done, and still so much work to beat the big man, Dusty Losh. Great play coming in from Ruan. What a try. You can't help but think that Impala, looking like the stronger side of them at the moment, all the momentum coming their way. Can East Rand United keep absorbing all this pressure?
Well, this is what club rugby is about. This is why SuperSport has invested into matches like this. It is so exciting. It is such a life and a spirit to it. As Francois van Billion to take it to 19.
Huge scrummage. That is a props try, but Stefan Kreer still had so much work to do, and he dots it down. He had a millimeter to work with. Great play from the substitute. The substitutions have brought some really good energy for this Newrak Impala side. They needed that. They find themselves only 10 points behind now.
Then Tour sends it deep. Maverick van der Merwe, his real name is Maverick, is the one who fielded it. Now it's a try score. Career.
Hold him. He left the play up. He wasn't a tackler. There's a tackler.
Not letting go of the ball. How strong has he been? Calvin Yankees. It's a second turnover coming onto the pitch.
Was he tackler?
It's a great inside ball coming from the big boy, Henro Hazer. It's just too much strength from Calvin Yankee. And what a play that is. Just to slow the game down and give this East Rand United a chance to get that momentum back on their side.
Lentour, he's certainly capable of putting this over. Doesn't have it. Van Billion.
22.
Dots are down. We have a 22. A lot of subs coming on. Fajan, one wonders how that might
five yellow
change the next 12 minutes of the game.
Wach, wach, wach.
Well, we saw a scrum, a huge scrum coming the way of
five
Impala.
Yellow.
A byproduct of that was a try in the corner coming from Stefan Berger, Kruger, rather. Huge steal from the 17 Yankees also coming on.
Now the big man that you just mentioned, Calvin Yankees. His ears were burning, as Fudge was saying, took the pass. Now it's the captain, JT Buerta. Lentour, Jonkers. Plays continued. Thundering tackle from Impala.
Check the tackle. Check the tackle. I don't know if it's fine. Just check the tackle number two, slipped up.
Now Sean De Wet slipping up and that causing the high tackle. No chances when it comes to the safety of the players. A huge moment for Newrak Impala now. Coming into the final 10 minutes of the game, how big is that man for a winger?
I had that exact same thought. Those guns would not be allowed on a plane, I'll tell you what.
Do me my Keshana. Wow.
He's got three nicknames. It's Dumi, Cobra, and Japan. My personal favorite is Cobra, although maybe given the World Cup, Japan could also be an option.
Yeah, what a steal that was.
Number four. Number four, pulling down.
Dustin Losh.
Number five, pulling down.
He was gesturing. The ref agrees.
Number four, blow.
30 seconds ago, it was a penalty coming their way. Unfortunately, Hazer unable to get it right at line-out time. Must be so frustrating for the backline players who kick for touch and unfortunately can't get the ball back to attack. Take nothing away from CJ Pale, though. What a steal that was. The tall, lanky number 19. Illegally pulling that maul down. Is there still some magic left in Cameron Lentour's boots?
Cameron Lentour, dad of CJ Daniel. What a beautiful backdrop. And what a beautiful kick! He hit the upright earlier. This time he gets it over. however, still touching the bar.
Tell me that man is not a magician, Anton. Yeah. How good has he been today?
Let's review this. This! No, that is fudge. That is out of this world.
Spectacular.
This game has it all, and you are right. Lentour is a magician, but someone else is a criminal. Peter and Gooney.
Playing the play in there.
Yeah, that was a yellow. Sheldon Gibson. Interestingly, he's number 19. He's also 19 years old, but he's 124 kilograms and 191. So now, once again, the momentum shifts, Fudge.
Now there it goes, and it's ill discipline. What a take by Mguni. Huge skill. Taken out in the air, though, unfortunately. That's dangerous play. Deserves to be sin-binned. Unfortunately, the worst-case scenario for Impala. Losing a man in the final 8 minutes and having to walk march back into their 22.
Hale takes it very well.
Sacking,
and I'll tell you what, East Rand United are not looking tired. Their captain, who's at the back leading it, has been tireless.
Swatson.
They were too energetic. It was taken so beautifully and so quickly. The beautiful hands from Olivier puts his man out. The kick. And as always, a magician up for it. He was able to just evade Mpete.
Really good play from Impala. Stefan Krier has been so good since he's come onto the pitch. Puts it to boot. So close for Itumpete. How good has the line-out been for East Rand United? Perfect execution.
So Brandon Hayward is coming on, as is MJ Teixeira. So the French row will have two players in the form of Janjis and Teixeira from CBC Boxburg.
Marciano Teixeira comes on for the number three, Saki Klaas, 39 years old. He's played almost a full game and he's scrummed his heart out. Great game for Saki Klaas. What a time for these substitutes to come on. The line-out has been perfect. Some fresh legs, they'll hope it even more perfect. Sean DeVitt has had a beautiful game. And so has Saki Klaas.
And Saki Klaas, like Dumisani Machachane, both born in a place where much club rugby has played. Ndansane, Pale takes it. Losh, Roy, the captain.
Play.
Stolen now. Henro Heysa.
And 14 points will put them 1 point ahead. Wins them the game for Impala. This game coming right down to the end. Be so interesting to see what they choose to do here. Yep, they go for the scrum.
What do you think of that?
Brilliant decision. Spot on. Great decision making from the captain. Yeah, he keeps. Yeah, he needs to let go of the ball. Does Vuyisile Ngweni, so it's worked so well off the ball. And now, are the alarm bells going off for East Rand United? They got dominated at their last scrum. Byproduct was a try coming in from Stefan Kruger. Both sides doing exceptionally at scrum time. Two sides to attack from. Is this the time now for Impala?
Set.
Krier lets his men do the work. Spinning toad now. Krier pumps it out. Mpete beats the first defender. Gets it out to the giant winger. And Dumisani Machichana gets his second fudge. This is the game the people came to watch.
Dumi Makeshana, the man from Mtanzane, 38 years old, fresh legs, all smiles, brilliant. Kriya's been so good since he's come on, but look at Itumpete, what a step still to be able to take that offload. And with one hand, the strong man with three men on his back puts it down. Couldn't have come at a better time for Newrak Impala. It's going right down to the wire, Anton Taylor. This is what I love about community rugby.
And there were three men on Machachana there. They couldn't stop him.
He's too big.
103 kilograms. Now, this is a huge kick now. No, he hasn't got it. So, 8 points up. They'll need to score twice.
And they could. Discipline has been bad from both sides. But look at the step. Oh, a goose step. Has the presence to pass it. But look at the strength of that man. Dumi Makeshana with a fantastic finish. Number 14 to number 11. Number 14, a classic sprinting winger. The number 11 loves taking it up. He keeps it solid. He keeps it close. Beautiful to watch, Anton. What a game.
When I'm 38, I want to look like Dumisani Machachana. So not too much pressure on the restart. So Kriya, that means there's some time. Gets out a fine pass. And the man who put in the magic puts in the kick now. The run coming in. Njomba. Can't stop, won't stop. Roy. Berto Klaassen, the captain, brings him down. And the hands come in from Van Jaarsveld. He turned it over. Surely Impala will run it now. They're looking at their big wings. It's come out the wrong side. And that is that. Another surprise in the story. The siren went off. Fudge, what do you make of this?
What a win. Huge game, huge win. They've beaten an unbeaten side. The champions of the Gold Cup, they haven't won a game all season, and this is how they turn it around. Brilliant play from East Rand United. It's rough and tough in Reiger Park. They were that way today. They loved it, and they worked off the ball. It was scrappy at times. They took advantage. They capitalized. They had perfect lineouts. That brought them four tries. And the kicking of Liebrock was unbelievable. Lentour's kicking was brilliant. That brings the score to 30-22. East Rand United win against Impala.